We mentioned multi-signature in the previous module in regards to pay-to-script hash, but just to explain again and elaborate on its potential uses, we generalize by saying that multisig enables what are called M of N transactions. In simple terms, multisig is a way of cryptographically sharing a key between participants and serves to distribute points of failure. Imagine if you want to share a wallet with your family or even with yourself. For example, consider a 2-of-3 multisig. Imagine I have a 2-of-3 multisig with my friends Derek and Gloria. Only two of us need to sign off on a transaction in order to send it. But no one can just run off with our Bitcoin, since you need at least 2-of-3 keys. And in this example, I've set up a 2-of-3 multisig with myself. Instead of losing my private key and then subsequently losing all of my funds, I have more than one point of failure. After losing one private key, I still have 2 of the 3 total keys, so I still have sufficient keys to access my funds in a 2-of-3 multi-signature scheme. As another example, some exchanges and software wallet companies provide 2-of-3 or 3-of-5 multi-sig services. In the 2-of-3 multi-sig case, you keep 2 of your keys, and a trusted third party, such as the company, holds the third. The exchange can't use your funds since they only have one key, but if you ever lose one of your keys, then the company can step in and offer their key to help you recover your funds. And as you can imagine, this works similarly for 3-of-5 or any other M of N multisig.